I want to ask you about this Saturday's main event. Chris Eubank Jr., Liam Smith. How do you see the fight going?
I fancy Liam again, to be honest with you. I think it'd be a lot better fight this time. I think he was shaping up quite nice last time until the ending. And I think we were all in shock, you know, with Eubank having such a good chin, how he got knocked out so early. I don't know whether it's because, you know, he was boiling himself down, wanting to fight Conor Benn, to be honest with you, not so long earlier. And I don't know whether that had a little bit to do with his resistance, because he'd lost that load of timber, hadn't he? You know what I mean? He got really, really low. And I don't know whether that affected his resistance in the fight. Probably not, because Liam's a very, very decent puncher. He wouldn't say murderous, but he can punch, you know what I mean? And he can punch, and at the level he's been fighting at. But I think it'll be a better fight this time. I think it'll be a lot closer fight. I think Liam winning, because I think he's just boxed in the better class. I think Chris, you know, has a very high opinion of himself, and I think he's only really boxed Billy Joe Saunders, for me, to be honest with you, and Liam now. And I just think Liam has boxed that little bit higher level, and I think that's what will give him the advantage. He's very seasoned, he's very experienced, and there's plenty in the tank yet. You know, he's not on his way out. I think a lot of people probably thought, oh, he's had better days, Liam, you know what I mean? But no, I think he's still fresh. I think he's still got a lot to give, which he clearly showed in the first fight. But I do think it will be a lot closer fight this time. A better fight, closer fight, but I see Liam winning. I think he's just boxed at that different level.
There's potential talks of this big super tournament in Saudi Arabia now. They're back on the table now, apparently, these talks in January, February, of a massive night with Usyk versus Fury, Joshua versus Wilder. Me personally, I believe it when I see it, but I would love it to happen. Those two fights, Ricky, how do they go? Tyson Fury versus Alexander Usyk, Anthony Joshua versus Deontay Wilder.
I think Tyson, you've got to pick Tyson over everyone, to be honest with you, haven't you? I mean, the danger is Tyson has proved that he can bully your Dillian Whites, he's bully your Deontay Wilders, which is no mean feat, is it, you know, to bully them. But if anyone's going to give it, he's shown that he can bully the bigger men, but, you know, would he be able to, you know, use it a little bit smaller, a little bit nippier, a little bit quicker? He's obviously not going to sit and have it out with Tyson like Dillian White did and Deontay Wilder did, for instance, and that. So could prove a difficult fight. But I think when you look at Tyson, it's just every area, you know, Usyk is a southpaw, very quick and very speed and very good, but, you know, Tyson's got the speed, Tyson's got the power, he's got the height, the reach, southpaw, orthodox, you know, he can bounce on the back foot, he can switch it, he can go forward. He just ticks too many boxes for me over Alexander Usyk. You know, he's everything what Usyk is, but bigger and longer reach and everything. So I think if anybody is going to beat Tyson Fury in boxing today, it will be Usyk, but I don't think he will know. Them fights must have took a lot out of Wilder, do you know what I mean? You know, them three fights with Fury, because they were absolute ding-dongs, you know. But the punching power of Deontay Wilder, you know, is there to be seen, you know what I mean? I think and AJ is stood in front, you know, he's not like a Fury. You know, that's all over the show. He's a little bit more upright, which worries me a little bit, because obviously, you know, we're in the AJ corner. But, you know, AJ is very, very good technical boxer. You don't get an Olympic gold medalist and, you know, and a two-time world heavyweight champion, you know, for nothing. He has got that boxing, a bit good boxing ability, and the punching power himself. Look at that knockout in that fight. That's frightening. He hits Wilder with one of them. Do you know what I mean? It's over, you know. So it's one of them. It's a real 50-50 for me. I think you toss a coin. I think whoever lands first. And I think I'd like to think AJ would get it in first. He's, you know, Wilder is murderous puncher, but you know what's coming. You know where he's technically not great, where AJ is technically pretty sound, isn't it? You know, so I think if anyone's going to get it in first, I'd like to think it'd be AJ. But it's a real toss the coin one, that, isn't it, to be honest? And I tell you what, you'd definitely pay to watch that one.